So I'm going to start by saying this is a good budget for a difficult time. We held extensive budget hearings, took lots of input, which implored us mostly to do even more. It is one of the joys of serving in Montgomery County, where most residents see the valuable role of government that government plays and would actually like us to do more to address the challenges that many in our community face. Or you could add environmental challenges, you could add just flat out school challenges. And these people believe that doing so makes this county a better place for everyone. And so for me, it's been a great privilege to be able to serve in an environment where you can talk about what's possible and not be limited to how much do I have to cut everything every year to simply fit the numbers. This budget holds the line on taxes and it funds the full operating budget of our school system, which many would argue is our most important asset. And we have that because our children are our most important asset. They are absolutely the future for us, and I think everybody recognizes that. And we, I think, will continue to be able to prosper as long as we continue to be a magnet with our schools. So it is absolutely important that we maintain them to the utmost. We are able to maintain our service levels largely, and we continue to do right by our employees who deliver those services. The executive provided a good base to start from, and that always makes this process a little bit easier. And I don't resent the fact that he takes the low-hanging fruit, even though all of us wish there was some fruit left on the tree so we could grab it and find some solutions on our own. But it's what he's supposed to do, and that's what makes his budget's balanced. The council was able to add some school and transit projects to the list of capital improvements, many of which have been waiting a long time, and we did it by adjusting another project, which shall remain nameless, in the capital budget that most of us felt had a somewhat lower priority. We made a commitment to our nonprofits that we would ensure the funding for them keeps pace with the minimum wage increases, and I've always felt that it was a moral responsibility that we have to own, and in fact, this council owned it. We expanded funding for Head Start as part of our commitment to expand efforts to broaden access to critical early childhood education. And this budget, I think, as a whole, strikes a fair balance between needs and available resources. As chair of the Public Safety Committee, I want to thank my two colleagues, Sydney and Tom, for their steadfast support of our committee recommendations. I particularly appreciate the committee's support for restoring the proposed cuts to the Fire and Rescue Service, which included preserving essential services like the paramedic engines in Hyattstown and Germantown, our aerial truck in Hillendale. We also restored emergency medical transport funds for the Volunteer Fire and Rescue Association. We added daytime staffing at the Burtonsville Fire Station and added funds to help the VCC Rescue Squad, which provides outstanding services in Montgomery County. And for anybody who wants to, as George alluded to, defend what we've done on preserving stations, I want to remind people that stations are not located strictly on call volume. The location of a station and services at a station are critical because of response times. You could have a low volume of calls, but if I can't get there in time, the number of calls is absolutely irrelevant. What this council did with the funding decisions we made is make sure that we're going to be able to provide adequate response times when people need to call 911, and that's what people should expect in this county. In the sheriff's office, we added funds to cover the cost of body-worn cameras, further demonstrating our commitment to transparency and accountability in law enforcement. And I would be remiss not to just say how amazing a law enforcement system we have here. I think, you know, we have an excellent police department and sheriff's department, and you know, it always amazes me that I get to say we have a jewel of a jail, but we really have a jail system that is focused on rehabilitation. It is almost unique in the country in the work it does, and that is significant. And I have lots of conversations with people, and there are people who assume that a jail is just a jail. And I can assure people the Montgomery County Jail and the work we do is unlike any other jail in the state. I appreciate the work of the community and career firefighters and the volunteers for their advocacy and for working well together. We couldn't fully fund everything in public safety, and there were worthwhile projects that will have to wait for funding, but we had to strike a balance between protecting core services and meeting needs within our resources. And I think as a whole, we struck a good balance. On the debt issue, because that does keep coming up, not building schools, fire stations, police stations, libraries that were all needed to serve this growing population, I think would have created a greater issue than the debt. And the fact is, the reason we turn to borrowing is because in the case of schools, we don't get enough money from the state, or you could argue we don't get enough money in impact fees to pay for the infrastructure that it takes to support what we provide. But either way, if you don't have money from those other sources and you intend to provide people with schools and services and the things they need, then ultimately we wind up borrowing to do these capital projects. It does have an interest cost, and I dearly hope that Craig is right and that the residents of the state pass the funding on the gambling, and that suddenly the county gets the money that, all, in fact, all the counties get the money they were promised a long time ago when we were led down the gambling road, told this is what we were going to do to save our school systems. So I hope that is what comes to pass. I want to thank my colleagues and thank many in all the communities for their advocacy and their willingness to work with us. This council, I think, has exhibited amazing restraint since the recession hit. We made some really difficult decisions then, and when the recession let up, I still don't believe it fully ended, but when the recession let up, the council actually considered or maintained what I think was a very thoughtful pattern of growing the budget and restraining increases in the budget, not because we didn't want to do things, but because I think we all recognized the fragility of the budgets and the fragility of the economy. And this year is no exception. There are real threats looming that could come down in November, December, that could really affect even the decisions we made inside this budget. And it was absolutely prudent not to extend this as far as many of us might have wanted to, because to have had to turn around only a few months from now and reel things back in, I think would have been extraordinarily difficult. It would be good to get good news in future years and be able to look at the things that we've been trying to do. But I think this is absolutely the best and most prudent budget we could have created in this year. I'm proud to have served as the residents' representative for the last 12 years. I've enjoyed my work here and enjoyed working with people in the community, and I think the county has a good future in front of it.